Hello students, welcome back. Students, today I'll tell you how to express hydronium ion concentration of a solution on pH scale. So students, here first we will discuss what is pH. So students, this pH stands for potens of hydrogen. Potens of hydrogen. And potens is a Greek word meaning power, or simply we say it is, potens means power, so it is power of hydrogen. It is power of hydrogen, that is power of hydrogen in the solution which is present as H positive. So this is pH. Now mathematically students, pH is defined as negative logarithm to the base 10 of H positive ion concentration, or we simply write it as pH is equal to minus log of we may write hydronium ion concentration. Why? Because in aqueous solution the hydrogen positive ions, they exist as hydronium ions. So this is how we calculate pH. Now students, say for a neutral solution, for a neutral solution. Now student, what is a neutral solution? A neutral solution is the one which has concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxyl ions equal, and say at 25 degrees Celsius it is 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. So students, here I must tell you that concentration of hydronium ion must be expressed in moles per liter. So this is concentration of hydronium ions. Now so therefore, what will be the pH of this neutral solution? Student, pH is minus negative log of hydronium ion concentration, and hydronium ion concentration is 10 raised to power minus 7. Now students, we solve this minus, and students, you must know this, that log of x upon m can be written as m log x. So this is a property of log. So here power is written first. So we write minus 7 log 10. So using this property, we write power first, and minus minus, that is plus. So we have 7. And students, log 10, remember this, log 10 is how much? Log 10 is 1. So we get 7. So students, remember this point now, that at 25 degrees Celsius, so when temperature of the solution is say 25 degrees Celsius, for a neutral solution, pH is how much? 7. Now students, secondly, say for acidic solution, how to find pH? Now student, what is an acidic solution? An acidic solution has hydronium ion concentration greater than hydroxyl ion concentration, which means it is also greater than say 10 raised to power minus 7. So you take any value which is greater than 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. Say the value is say 10 raised to power minus 6. Now 10 raised to power minus 6 is 10 times greater than 10 raised to power minus 7. So students, in this case the pH of the solution would be minus log, and concentration of hydronium ion, we are assuming it is 10 raised to power minus 6. So again, when we solve this, we get minus minus 6 log 10, and log 10 is 1, so this is 6. So students, what we are getting is that for acidic solution whose concentration is 10 raised to power say minus 6, pH is 6. And 6 is what? Less than 7. So students, remember this point now, that any solution which has pH less than 7 will be what? Acidic. Whereas solution which has pH 7 will be what? Neutral. Now student, we'll calculate pH of a basic solution. Now, for a basic solution, So for a basic solution, now student, what is basic solution? A basic solution is the one which has what? Hydronium ion concentration less than the hydroxyl ion concentration. Say at 25 degrees Celsius, we say it is less than 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. So -7, 10 raised to power -7 से लेस कोई भी वैल्यू लेना. सपोज स्टूडेंट्स वी टेक 10 रेस टू पावर से -8 विच इज 10 टाइम्स स्मॉलर देन दिस वैल्यू. सो नाउ स्टूडेंट हाइड्रोनियम आयन कंसेंट्रेशन दिस सॉल्यूशन इज 10 रेस टू पावर -8. सो वी आर अज्यूमिंग इट इज दिस. सो व्हाट विल बी द पीएच ऑफ दिस सॉल्यूशन? पीएच इज नेगेटिव लॉग ऑफ hydronium ion concentration. So it is say 10 raised to power minus 8. So minus minus power is written first. Log 10 is 1. So students, we get 8. And 8 is what? 8 is greater than 7. So students, now we have again made a conclusion that for a basic solution, pH is greater than 7. So finally students, I have a conclusion that at 25 degrees Celsius, students, this is very important to note that this data which I am using is applicable only at this temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius or 298 Kelvin. So when pH of solution is 7, we say solution is what? Neutral. And when pH is less than 7, we say solution is acidic. And when pH is greater than 7, we say solution is what? Basic. So it is very easy to remember this fact, but student, this is applicable only at 25 degrees Celsius. So finally students, I can say that say if I have a scale from 0 to say 14, this is generally the scale which we use at 25 degrees Celsius. And say this is if 7. At this point, we say solution is what? Neutral. Now, this side on moving 7 to 14, we say solution is basic. And when we move, say from 7 to 0, we say solution is acidic. Which means as pH of solution say increases, the basic character increases, or when we say pH of solution is decreasing, that means acidic character is increasing. So when pH is say less than 7, solution is acidic. Now students, say I have two solutions A and B with pH. So with say one has pH 5, the other solution has pH say 2. Now students, which solution is more acidic? So student, lower the pH, greater the acidic character. So here we would say that solution B is more acidic. Now similarly student, I am taking another example. So I have two solutions A and B, and their pH values are say 10 and 14. Now students, which solution is more basic? So again students, greater the pH, more the basic character. So here again we find that since solution B has greater pH, it is more basic. So student, this was pH. Now students, I'll tell you how to calculate pH. Students, so the first question is calculate the pH of 0.01 mole per liter aqueous hydrochloric acid solution. So students, how to calculate pH of solution whose concentration is given? First, let me tell you students, this solution is aqueous, which means HCl is dissolved in water. And since it is dissolved in water, we should write that water also undergoes ionization to give this. And student, assuming that the temperature is 25 degrees Celsius. So we are assuming that temperature is 25 degree Celsius. The hydronium ion concentration in the solution is 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. And this is also 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. Now student, when we add say HCl to water, what happens? Students, water mein HCl, HCl is a strong acid, so it undergoes ionization completely to give hydronium ions and chloride ion, which means one mole of HCl will produce one mole of hydronium ion, means concentration of hydronium ion will be same as that of HCl. Now concentration of HCl is given, it is 0.01, and this can be written as 10 raised to power minus 2. So 10 raised to power minus 2 mole per liter of HCl will produce how many hydronium ion? It will produce 10 raised to power minus 2, and chloride ions again equal, because 1 mole produces 1 mole of hydronium and 1 mole of chloride. Now students, see this. We have to find out pH, and pH is decided by concentration of what? Hydronium ions. It is decided by concentration of hydronium ions. So hydronium ion concentration in the solution will be what? 10 raised to power minus 3, sorry, minus 2, plus 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. Now students, very important point, that this 10 raised to power minus 7 as compared to 10 raised to power minus 2 is negligible. So this is almost negligible, means it is very small as compared to what? 10 raised to power minus 2. So generally in pH calculation, when the concentration of acid which is given is higher than that of 10 raised to power minus 7 moles of hydronium ions, we ignore this value. So approximately we will take 10 raised to power minus 2. So this is the hydronium ion concentration in moles per liter. And now students, what will be the pH? pH is negative log of hydronium ion concentration, which is 10 raised to power minus 2. And solving this, we get minus 2 log what, 10, and minus minus plus log 10 is 1. So students, your answer is what? 2. So student, answer of this question is 2. So this is how we find what pH. So here this point is very important, that why this value is ignored or not taken into consideration, because it is very very small as compared to the given concentration of the acid. Now similarly, we have one more example students. Now calculate the pH of 0.005 moles per liter solution of sulfuric acid. So again, this is we are assuming this solution is aqueous. Now student, this is very important to note, that this is aqueous. So in water, first self-ionization takes place. And self-ionization of hydronium ions produces how many hydronium ions? 10 raised to power minus 7 moles per liter. But students, sulfuric acid in water undergoes ionization, and we know that it is strong as well as dibasic. So upon complete ionization, it will give 2 hydronium ions and what? Sulfate ion. Now the concentration of this is given 0.005, so 0.005 moles per liter. Now students, but the concentration of hydronium ion will be double, because ek molecule iska do moles de raha, so ek mole se do moles aate hain. That means the concentration of hydronium ion is double that of concentration of sulfuric acid, so it is double of 0.005, and this will be it is 1 only, so it is 0.005. Now students, this is 0.5 to the 10, so it is 0.01. So this is hydronium ion concentration which we get from sulfuric acid. Now again student, this is 10 raised to power minus 2, and this value as compared to 10 raised to power minus 7 is quite high. सो दिस वैल्यू इज देयर फॉर वॉट नेग्लिजिबल, इसको हम नेग्लेक्ट कर देंगे, सो दिस इज नेग्लिजिबल. सो फाइनली वी से दैट हाइड्रोनियम आयन कंसेंट्रेशन इन द सॉल्यूशन इज 10 रेस टू पावर माइनस 2 ओनली, बिकॉज इसको तो हमने नेग्लेक्ट कर दिया. सो वी हैव दीज मेनी मोल्स पर लीटर एंड अगेन पीएच इज वॉट माइनस लॉग ऑफ 10 रेस टू पावर माइनस 2. सो स्टूडेंट आंसर इज अगेन 2. सो पीएच ऑफ दिस सॉल्यूशन इज ऑल्सो 2. Now student, this is very very important point that while calculating pH, you have to see what is the basicity of acid. Like here concentration was 0.01 and that is 10 raised to power minus 2, we are getting pH 2. Here the concentration is different but still pH is 2 because sulfuric acid is a dibasic acid. So the hydronium ion concentration will be double of the concentration of sulfuric acid and that is why we are getting same result. Now students, I'll tell you how to calculate pH of a solution. Students, now through this question, I will tell you how to calculate pH of a solution of an alkali or a base. Now students, one very important thing, first I must tell you that when we add acid or base to water, what happens? The hydronium and hydroxyl ion concentrations change, but ionic product of water remains constant. That means Kw at a given temperature is always constant. And what is Kw? It is concentration of hydronium ion into hydroxyl ion. Student, this we have studied earlier, that Kw is product of molar concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxyl ions. So at any given temperature, when we add acid or base to water, the ionic product of water however does not change, though solution may become acidic or basic. So this is very very important point, because using this point we will calculate what is the concentration of OH negative ion. Now students, see, I have a solution of sodium hydroxide aqueous. Now this sodium hydroxide, we know that it is a strong base, it is an alkali, so it undergoes almost complete dissociation into ions. Now students, see, 1 mole of this will give 1 mole of sodium ion and 1 mole of hydroxyl ion, but what is the concentration given? It is 0.01, so 0.01 moles per liter of sodium hydroxide will give 0.01 moles per liter of sodium ion and 0.01 moles per liter of hydroxyl ion. So students, hydroxyl ion concentration we have 0.01 moles per liter, that is 10 raised to power minus 2 moles per liter. But students, in order to calculate pH, we need what? Hydronium ion concentration. So hydronium ion concentration will calculate using this. Hydronium ion concentration will be what? It is Kw upon hydroxyl ion concentration. And Kw we know it is 10 raised to power minus 14 always at 25 degrees Celsius upon hydroxyl ion concentration. So hydronium ion concentration therefore would be what? Kw, which is 10 raised to power minus 14 upon hydroxyl ion concentration, which is 10 raised to power minus 2. So students, we get hydronium ion concentration as 10 raised to power what? Minus 12 moles per liter. Now students, we can easily calculate pH, because pH is what? Minus log of hydronium ion concentration, that is 10 raised to power minus 12. Now this will be minus 12 log 10, and students, log 10 is what? This is 12, log 10 is 1, so answer is 12. So this solution has pH 12. And since it is greater than 7, we say sodium hydroxide is a strong base, as it is quite high. Now students, a very important topic is that the pH of a solution can also be predicted by the action of a universal indicator. Universal indicator. Now student, what is an universal indicator? So students, universal indicator is actually a mixture of several dyes. That means it is a mixture of several indicators which gives different color changes depending upon pH of the solution. Students, earlier also I had told you about indicators like litmus, methyl orange, phenolphthalein. But students, those indicators are not universal. They give a characteristic color change depending upon a particular pH range. But universal indicator give color changes in all types of what solutions. But the color will be different according to pH. So for example, students, say if I have a pH scale. Okay. So we have, say, here we have, say, 0, then we have 1, say this is 1, then we have 3, we have 5, so 7, then I have 9, then say 11, then 13, and then last we have, say, 40. So this is a pH scale. Now students, at a solution which has a pH 13 will have violet color. So any solution which gives a violet color with universal indicator will have pH 13. This will be indigo color. So pH 11 hoga, so indigo. Then we have blue color. So that means a solution which has pH 9 will show blue color. Then a solution which has pH 7, that is neutral solution ke liye, universal indicator kya color dega? Green. Then for solution whose pH is 5, the color with this indicator would be yellow. And then students, for this solution again it will be pink. And for a solution which is strongly acidic, the color is red. So we can predict the pH of a solution by what? Noticing the color with universal indicator. So students, this is it for today. Till now students, we had discussed the acids, bases and their properties. So in next lecture, I'll give you some questions, or I'll give you some practice questions based on the properties of acids and bases. Thank you, students.